Welcome to Jubilee Farm, Northern Ireland's first community-owned farm. I'm Dr Jonny Hanson, farmer, conservationist and social entrepreneur. And along with a team of staff, interns and volunteers, I run this fantastic farm. And this week, I'm inviting you to join me and the team as we take a behind-the-scenes look at the science behind Jubilee Farm, looking at the science of soil, the science of plants, the science of livestock, the science of wildlife, and also the science of human beings and our involvement in all of this, not only as custodians of this small farm in Northern Ireland, but that is a proxy for us as custodians for life on planet Earth. For the first day of our science behind the farm tour of Jubilee Farm, we're looking at the really important issue of soil. Soil is the building block of life on the farm. It's where it all begins. And soil itself is this fantastic ecosystem, really, that is so important to life on Earth, and yet we know very little about it compared to what exists above ground. In fact, soil is so full of life that scientists estimate about a quarter of all biodiversity lives beneath our feet. In fact, in a single teaspoon of healthy soil, there are more living things than there are people on planet Earth. That's 7.5 billion and counting. The soil beneath our feet is bursting at the seams with life. And its soil itself is made up of different components. It's firstly made up of inorganic material, and that's really rocks and stones being ground down over thousands and millions of years. That slow process of grinding it down creates the inorganic material that is one of the major parts of soil. But soil is also full of organic material, living things that are decaying and breaking down, things like plants that are dying, dying animals, even us as human beings, often buried in the soil. But as well as those inorganic and decaying materials, as I mentioned already, soil is full of living things. All those tiny little microorganisms that are invisible to the naked eye. But there's one creature that lives in the soil that is particularly fascinating. It does a really important job for farmers and for food production all around the world. And it's really the charismatic megafauna of the soil. And that species is, of course, the earthworm. And here's one that I dug up earlier. Earthworms really are marvelous creatures. A single earthworm in 24 hours can digest its own weight in soil. That's the equivalent of me eating 90 kilos of soil every day, or in a month, 2.7 tons. That's, say, roughly the size and weight of this vast pile of earth here. I did have a thought about maybe, like the earthworm, giving that a go, but I think on second thoughts, we'll leave eating soil and moving soil to earthworms, nature's earth-moving machines. The next stage in the story of soil is composting. Whenever you produce food on a farm, whether you're producing vegetables or animals, like we do both of here at Jubilee Farm, you're essentially, in its purest form, taking energy and nutrients out of the soil. And if you keep doing that year after year, taking out that energy and those nutrients, the soil ends up being depleted and you are left with lower yields, diseases, pests, sick animals, and all the rest of it. So what's important in any farming system is really to return energy and nutrients to the soil, feeding the soil so that it's healthy, producing healthy plants and healthy animals. There's lots of different inputs that you can put into the soil. Industrial agriculture has favoured fossil fuel based inputs, but here at Jubilee Farm, we're an agroecological farm. That means we work with the grain of nature and not against it. It means that our inputs are renewable and sustainable. And one of our most important inputs that we put back into the soil to feed it is something that we make right here in the farm, and that is compost. And composting is a really simple and important process, something you can do at home as well. But making compost is a bit like making a cake. It's all about getting the different layers and different materials. So you can see that here, you need two different types of layers when you're making compost. You need green stuff. In this case, this is old discarded leeks, the final leek harvest of the year. You can see all of that green stuff in there. So you need things that have been alive, sources of nitrogen, but you also need then brown stuff. So shredded paper, shredded cardboard. In our case, we have lots of straw that's been bedding material for animals, and being a farm that's also full of manure and urine, which are fantastic for returning nutrients to the soil and making really good compost. And compost is all about mixing that up and allowing the microorganisms and even the earthworms that come up to be involved in that process. Composting involves the breaking down of all of that material over time. And you can speed it up in a number of ways. We speed it up by turning it. So our volunteers and our interns, we call it the Green Gym because it's such a good workout. They turn, once this is full, this bay, they turn it into this bay. And then when that bay is full again, everything gets turned again into this bay. And what you can see here already, which probably isn't there in that first bay, is that you can see that the compost has started to fill up with worms. So this is worms coming up from the soil beneath. And again, starting to, like they do in the soil underneath our feet, within the compost, starting that process and speeding up the process of composting. Some of these compost bins, particularly in summer, there's so much activity going on with all those microorganisms inside the compost. And as things break down, that when you start to turn these compost bays, steam comes out of it. They're emitting so much heat, it's incredible. And the last stage then, when it gets to the compost stage, is dressing the beds that we grow vegetables on. So returning it to the soil, covering them over in winter, as you can see today, as we put the market garden to bed for the winter. And again, the earthworms are involved then in drawing that compost into the soil, returning those nutrients so that at the beginning of spring again, we're ready to go with fertile soil to grow vegetables. Like the diversity of soil beneath our feet and also the composting process, soil is a really important component of farming and component of life on earth. And whether it's through composting or good soil management practices, soil is something that we really need to look after on Jubilee Farm and around the world.